Good morning, children. In the last class, we had seen that Nerissa was asking Portia about her opinion regarding the different suitors. Now, we will begin from line number 60. Nerissa says, "How say you? What do you think about the French lord, Monsieur Lebon?" Children, Monsieur is a French expression for sir. So she means to say, what is your opinion about Sir Lebon? Portia says, God has created him and therefore let him pass, let him be accepted to be a man. In truth, I know it is a sin. Portia says that it is true, and I know also that it is a wrong thing to be a mocker. To be a mocker means to laugh at anybody. But he means Lebon. Why? He hath a horse better than the Neapolitans. Means he talks even more about his horse than the Neapolitan prince. He also has a better bad habit of frowning. Better means more. His habit of frowning is more than the Count Palatine. He is every man in no man. Means he has a character. Portia says that Lebon is every man in no man. Means he has a character of everybody, but has no personality of his own. If a throstle is an English bird. Commonly it is called thrush. So if a thrush sings, he is referred to Lebon. He falls straight a capering. Straight a capering means he starts jumping up and down. He will fence with his own shadow. He fights with his own shadow. And Portia says that if she marries Lebon, she should marry 20 husbands together, because this person has characters of every different person. If he would despise me, if Lebon hates me, hates Portia is ready to forgive him. But if Lebon says that he loves Portia to madness, Portia shall never be able to requite him. Requite him means to return his love. Now Nerissa says, fine, what do you have to say about Falcon Bridge, who is the young Baron of England? Falcon Bridge has come from England. Then Portia says, you know, I say nothing to him. I say nothing to him means I do not converse with him. I do not talk to him. Why? For he neither understands me, nor do I understand his language. He hath neither Latin. He hath means he does not understand the language Latin, French or Italian language. And you will come to the court, and you will come to the court means you can take me to the court and make me swear that I have a poor pennyworth, I have a poor knowledge in the English, and the Baron of England only understands English. He is a proper man's picture. Proper man's picture means he is handsome. But alas, I am so sorry. Who can talk, who can converse with a dumb show? With a dumb show means a person who cannot understand words. And he is dressed very oddly, strangely. He dresses in a strange manner. I think he bought his doublet. Doublet means jacket in Italy. His round hose means his trousers seem to have been brought from France, and his bonnet, that is his hat, from Germany. And his behavior, his manners, he has copied from everywhere. Now, Nerissa asks Portia, okay, what is your opinion about the Scottish Lord? His neighbor, whose neighbor? He is the neighbor of Falcon Bridge. Scottish Lord. Portia says that he hath, means that he has a neighborly charity. Neighborly charity means a helpful nature within him. For, because he borrowed, he was given a box of the ear. A box of the ear means a blow on the ear of the Englishman, from the Englishman. This means that the Scottish Lord was given a blow by the Englishman, and the Scotland Lord, he promised he would pay him back, means he would take the revenge when he was able, when he got the opportunity. I think Portia feels that the Frenchman became his surety. The Frenchman, who is this Frenchman? Lebon. He became the guarantor and sealed under for another. And sealed under means he assured him that definitely he would speak for him and help him to take the revenge when the Scottish Lord got the chance. Then Nerissa says, actually children, here you have to remember one thing, that this Scotland and the French, it is a reference made about the help, the assistance which was given to the French, to the Scots, when they had quarrels or fights with the English. It is a reference from history. The French were at war with the English, and sorry children, just listen again. The French helped the Scots. The people, the Scottish people, were at war with English, and whenever they needed help, the French helped them. So here also, the English Lord had given a blow to the Scottish Lord, and he was being helped by the French Lord Lebon, who agreed to become his guarantor. Then Nerissa, continuing her questions, asks, what do you think, Portia, about the young German who is the Duke of Saxony's nephew? He is the Duke of the nephew of Saxony. What is your feeling about him? He has also come. Come for what? To, as a suitor to woo you. Portia says very wildly, I hate him in the morning when he is sober. Sober means little drunk. And more wildly, I hate him more in the afternoon because he is totally drunk. And when he is best, means when he is not drunk, he is a little worse than a man. His behavior is not adequate to that of a man. And when he is worst, and when he is completely drunk, he is little better than a beast. You can call him a little better than a wild creature. And the worst fall that ever fell, and even if the worst thing comes to my life, I hope I shall make shift. I shall make shift means I can always go without him. I can make shift. I can manage to go without him, to not depend on him. That is the young German. When Portia tells Nerissa regarding her opinion of the young German, then Nerissa, on hearing Portia's response, asks her, what will you do if the young German wants to choose, and if he chooses the right casket, will you refuse to do according to your father's will, and you will refuse to marry him? Portia says, no, my dear, that is why. Therefore means keeping that in mind for fear of the worst. What is the fear of the worst? That if this man chooses the right casket, I pray thee, I request you, Nerissa, set, keep a deep, a big glass of Rhenish wine. Rhenish is a white wine made from grapes. You keep a big glass of white wine on the contrary, on the wrong casket. For if the devil be inside, devil is the temptation of wine. That man always has the temptation of wine, which is referred to the devil. If the devil is inside and that temptation outside, temptation is the glass of wine. He has the devil of drinking, and the wine will be kept outside on the wrong casket. I know. He will choose the wine bottle. I will do anything, Nerissa. Means before I get married to the sponge. Sponge means just as a sponge soaks up anything, this man soaks up liquor. He is a drunkard. Then Nerissa says, listen, you need not fear, lady. The having of any of these lords means that any of these lords have to be accepted by you. Why? Because they have acquainted me, told me with about their decisions, their determinations, their decisions, which is indeed to return to their home. They all want to go back to their respective places and to trouble you with no more suit, and they are not going to request you to marry them unless you may be one, unless if there is any other way to win you, some other sort, some other type of test than your father's imposition, than the conditions which your father has imposed, that is dependence on the caskets or choosing the right casket. Now Portia says, if I live to be as old as Sibylla, who is this Sibylla? According to Roman mythology, Sibylla was a foreteller of future, and God Apollo had granted her, Apollo was the sun god, he had granted her as many years of life, as long as she could hold sand grains in her hand. Now children, definitely sand grains you can hold for many years. So as long as sand grains would be in her feast, she would not die. So Portia says, even if I grow as old as Sibylla, I will die as chaste, as pure, as Diana. Now Diana, according to Roman mythology, she was a virgin, a maiden, unmarried girl. And she was also the goddess of moon and the goddess of hunting. So Portia says that nobody will be able to choose the right casket. I will live to be as old as Sibylla, and that too unmarried. Unless I be obtained, unless somebody tries to choose me by the manner of my father's will, unless somebody chooses the right casket, I am glad this parcel, this crowd of wooers, suitors are so reasonable they are so rational in their thought. For there is not one among them, but I dote means whom I long to marry, on his very absence. And if among these crowd of people or suitors who had come, there is nobody who can enter my life, or whom I want to be absent from my life. And I pray God that God helps them to give them a safe journey back to their own homes. Nerissa says, okay, Portia, do you remember, lady, that in your father's time, when your father was alive, a Venetian, a person from Venice, who was a scholar and a soldier. Here in these two adjectives, Nerissa is ironic. She is speaking about Bassanio as a scholar and a soldier. Bassanio is none of these. Continuing her speech, Nerissa says, do you remember that person who came here in the company, means together with the Marquis of Montferrat? The Marquis of Montferrat is the title of an Italian nobleman. Okay, so Nerissa tries to remind Portia about Bassanio. Portia remembers him very well, but she pretends to forget him. And she says, oh yes, yes, it was Bassanio as I think. Isn't his name, it wasn't his name Bassanio? Nerissa says, very true, madam. And he means Bassanio. Of all the men, among all the suitors that ever my foolish eyes looked upon, that ever I have known, was the best deserving a fair lady. He is only the best person who can deserve a beautiful, wise, virtuous lady like you. Portia now says, I remember him well, and I remember him worthy of thy praise. Means, yes, I can recall Bassanio, and I know he is capable of your praise. At that very moment, a servant comes. Then Portia asks him, yes, what news have you brought? The servant says, the four strangers seek for you, want to meet you, madam, to take their leave, to take formal permission from you to go back. And there is a forerunner, there is a messenger who has come from a fifth suitor, and he is the Prince of Morocco. The suitor is the Prince of Morocco, and who brings word, means the messenger brings information that the Prince of Morocco, who is his master, will be reaching here tonight. He will be reaching Belmont tonight. Portia says, if I could only bid the fifth welcome, if I could only welcome the Moroccan prince with so good a heart, with so cheerful a heart, as I am bidding the other four farewell, as I am bidding these four suitors farewell with a cheerful heart, I am unable to welcome the fifth one. I should be glad of his approach, and if I could welcome him cheerfully, I should be happy of his coming. If he have the condition of a saint, if he, means the Prince of Morocco, has the condition, has the nature of a saint, of a holy man, and the complexion of a devil, and even if he looks like a devil, I had rather means I would be happy if he should shrive me. If he should shrive means if he should listen to me rather than wive me. Means if the person has the complexion of a devil, and if he could listen to what I want to say him and forgive me for not marrying him rather than marrying me, I would be very happy. Come, Nerissa, we will see. Sira is being told to the servant. She is telling you, Sira, you go before us. While we shut the gate upon one suitor, wooer means shooter. We are trying to shut the gate upon one suitor, another one is ready knocking at the door. Indirectly, Portia means to say she has no peace at all. Children, with this we come to the end of Act 1, Scene 2. Please listen to the video again and again so that the passage, the text will be clear to you. That is why I am uploading this in